Hello there.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Fandom Fights. I am Tim. That is Nick. Nick, how are you? What's wrong? We're here for a Fandom Fights match. Is there something?
It's a retirement match, Nick. I didn't know that.
Yep. Sad day.
Well, shit. Okay.
Nick, this was a bit, but I accidentally made myself cry.
Nick, Carley, Maddie, Chen. Two people I like very much. This is sad, but only one can survive. Nick, how did we get here?
Both, I think, good players in their own right. They just haven't found success, or at least found success recently. Matthew went on a pretty long losing streak last year. Continued that early this year against the now retired Mike Shea. So that's how he punched his ticket here. Nick, Carley has had very narrow losses, about four of them. Unfortunately, they were in a row, and he has yet to find that success. So they found themselves here today. The winner can go on. We've seen fantastic players win retirement matches.
Albert,
the loser, I hope, comes. Yeah, absolutely. And the loser, I hope, comes back in teams, because I do like seeing both these guys around, but one of them will be ending their singles career today.
I was going to say that from the get-go. We don't know who's going to win today. Believe it or not, we don't plan these things. But I do want to make sure. I know Matthew Chen is on a team. Nick, Carley, get on a team. I want to see you next season if you don't make it out of this. But Matthew, I know, will be here next season if he doesn't make it out. So get on teams. I'm super excited about the match anyway, because as I've been saying, I like it when we're here with good people playing fun trivia, having a good time. And I think these are two great guys. So let's get into it, starting with the promos.
Well, we're here. I've had some very, very close matches, big mistakes that had me, you know, that caused me to get to where I am today. I dressed up nicely just in case it does end up being my funeral in singles. But other than that, I've always had fun in this league, and for my opponent, don't expect much trash talk, if at all, because, I mean, you've seen both of us play. Neither of us are going to be trash talking the other person. Matthew Chen, I know, is he's a really good player. I'm honestly surprised he's in a retirement match with me. So I'm just going to relax, have a good time, answer as many questions as I can, and best of luck to both of us. Let's hope it's a good one.
Yeah, it sucks to be in a retirement match, but I mean, I've had a lot of rough luck in the past few matches. And so, you know, I mean, Nick is a great guy. So I just hope we have some fun. And, you know, if I lose, at least I still have teams. And hopefully Nick has a team partner if he loses.
I'm glad Nick followed it up, because when he initially was like, I'm not going to trash talk my opponent, I was like, ah, yes, Matthew Chen, the king of trash talk. So I'm glad he clarified that they're both nice guys and they're both not going to be trashing. This is going to be fun. Nick, your thoughts?
Yes, very sad day. And now it's even worse because Anna burned her grilled cheese.
I was sad before, but God damn it, Nick, read round one.
Round number one is going to work like this. There's going to be 10 questions in the realm of Fandom Fights. Once the players hear the question, they'll have 15 seconds to write down the answer. At the end of 15 seconds, we'll say pens down, at which point the players will reveal what they wrote. Oh, wow. That was weird. I just smell of burnt grilled cheese. Each question is worth 1 point apiece. Any individual player get all 10 questions correct from round number one. They would receive a bonus question. Each player will have three repeats, one challenge for the entirety of the match. Players, any questions as we get into round number one?
Okay, take it away, Nick.
This question comes in the category of the MCU. What are the real first names of both Maximoff twins in Avengers: Age of Ultron?
Nick, because this is a retirement match and we're trying to be, you know, gentle and nice and stuff, are you only going to ask questions about good movies?
About what?
Good movies.
No.
Also, I think Nick Carley might be frozen.
Oh, God.
Four. Three.
Oh, sorry. I thought I disconnected. Sorry.
Are you back, Nick?
I'm sorry. I'm here. Yeah.
Did you hear the question, Nick?
Yes, I heard the question. I heard the question that it went dark.
What is your answer, Nick?
I got it. I got one of them right. I couldn't remember the other guy's name, but
okay.
Yeah. So, I heard the question.
Matthew, go ahead.
Wanda and Pietro.
Wanda and Pietro is correct. And we're gonna cut right here and be right back. All right, we're back. Matthew had it correct, so it's 1-0 as we get into your next question, which is in the category of Wizarding World. Which Wizarding World film is the first to feature a Niffler? Ellie has a Niffler.
Could I have a bite of the burnt grilled cheese?
Dude, you know what we did for dinner?
What's that?
Chicken quesadillas made on the stove. Yeah, they were really good. Put some sour cream and some salsa on there. That shit was great. Five. Four.
That's a bad part of the question.
One. Hands down. Let's go to Matthew.
Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them.
And Nick?
Barely got it in time. Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them.
Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them is correct. So Nick is on the board. It's 2-1. What's next, Nick? Or do you want me to take it while you choose?
Third question comes in the category of Star Trek. Who plays George Kirk in 2009's Star Trek?
Nick, you might want to lean your board up a little bit. There you go.
Okay.
2-3 on good movies so far. I like The Age of Ultron. I like the Star Trek.
calling you out over there.
No. I will never forget seeing that movie the first time and just being pissed. Five, four, three, two, one. Pens down. Let's go to Nick.
Chris Hemsworth.
And Matthew.
Yeah, I forgot. I just picked Chris Pine because I can't remember.
Chris Hemsworth is correct. So two of the beautiful Chrises in that film. Nick ties up 2-2. Your next question is going to be in the category of Disney animation. What type of animal is Chicken Little's friend Abby in Chicken Little? What's up?
We just watched this recently.
Oh, so you're trying to tell her not to scream.
Correct.
Like if the answer was ice cream, she wouldn't just be able to like yell like ice cream.
Right. Might as well put something.
Xbox. Like, yeah.
Did you say four? Xbox?
Yeah. One. Pens down. I realize that ice cream could be construed as like maybe a cow or something. So I... let's go to Matthew.
I said duck.
And Nick.
I just said donkey.
Duck is
correct. Duck. Okay. All right.
So 3-2 is the score. Nick, what's next?
Your next question comes in the category of DreamWorks animation. Which member of the Guardians protests the Man in the Moon's decision of inducting Jack Frost as a Guardian in Rise of the Guardians?
Is it weird that I also read the word including as you were reading
along? A little bit?
Oh, damn. I was going to tell you something. Now I don't remember. Oh, God.
Whoa, just take it easy, man.
Oh, just so frustrated. Sorry, Bucky. Didn't mean to rile you up. Chicken Little's a bad movie.
I don't think so.
It's not great. Five.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Three, two, one. Down. This is a great movie, though. Let's go to Nick.
Good one I haven't seen in a while. I just put Santa Claus.
And Matthew.
Yeah, I also haven't seen it in a while, so I just said Santa.
Both are incorrect. We're looking for the Easter Bunny.
Ah, the Easter Bunny.
Okay. Easter Bunny. All right. Your next question is coming in the category of sci-fi icons. Your question is, which sci-fi icons film features the characters Ultra Magnus, Spike Witwicky, and Hot Rod? What? Did I say something wrong?
No.
Was it the way I said something?
Yeah.
What did I say?
I don't know. You just struggled in a weird spot.
Witwicky?
Now, I know reading's hard.
Ultra, it is. You know that I used to be like one of Anna's students, right?
Yes, I'm aware.
Okay.
I was like, Anna did not do her job very well.
2-1, pens down. Let's go to Matthew.
I said Transformers, Dark of the Moon.
Let's go to Nick.
I knew it was Transformers. I didn't have anything any specific, so I guess I went the first one.
Both incorrect. We're looking for the animated one, The Transformers.
Dang. Okay.
That one where they sing that song that everyone likes. Nick, what's next?
Your next question comes in the category of epic adventures. How is it believed that Jack killed Barbossa at the end of Pirates of the Caribbean, The Curse of the Black Pearl, only for him to be revealed that he is alive in later films?
I thought that was definitely done, and then it kept going.
It's okay. I'm not gonna shame our writers for adding context.
No, never.
It's good.
Nick. No. It is, we are past the spooky season. We're past turkeys even now at this point.
Yeah, it's like,
have a great holiday.
Yeah, it was great. I'm full. Lots of candy too.
Oh my God. Let's go to Nick.
I just put Stabbed. I hate that I missed this question. I love this movie.
And Matthew.
I don't remember. I said Hunt.
Both incorrect. We're looking for Shoots.
Shoots. All right. He does shoot him.
All right, guys. Your next question is coming in the category of the Worlds of DC. Which Worlds of DC character said the quote, "What does he do? Throw polka dots at people?" He does. He throws polka dots at people. I tried to act a little bit in that one, Nick.
Just a little, but you also don't want to act too much.
Because then I could sway.
Yeah.
Going to a concert tomorrow night, Nick.
Who are you seeing?
Marianas Trench.
Wow. That's crazy because you saw them like 2 months ago.
I know. We're going again. We love them so much. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down. Let's go to Matthew.
That's Peacemaker.
And Nick.
I also said Peacemaker.
You both are correct. So it is 4-3 in favor of Matthew. Nick, what's next?
Your penultimate question comes in the category of Marvel. Who plays Hannibal King in Blade Trinity?
I watched multiple spooky films tonight.
Multiple? Wow. Yeah, we've been watching a couple.
One is a fandom film, one is not a fandom film.
Yeah, you said one was Terrifier.
Terrifier 3.
Yeah, no, I get it.
5, 4, 3. That was the hint. 2, 1. Pens down. Let's go to Nick.
Ryan Reynolds.
And Matthew.
I also said Ryan Reynolds.
Ryan Reynolds is correct. So keeping pace, 5-4, as we get into your final question in this round. It's in the category of Pixar. In Toy Story 2, when Buzz and the toys set out to find Woody, Mrs. Potato Head packs an extra pair of what type of eyes for Mr. Potato Head?
Appreciate you.
I know. I appreciate you. For very different reasons, but... Well, you don't normally have to, like, add on to questions. Oh.
It's not very different.
I guess it's not very different. You write questions.
It could be like, you pull the plow on my family's farm.
That would be very different. 3, 2, 1. Pens down. Let's go to Matthew.
Angry.
And Nick.
Fuck. I did scary.
Your angry eyes.
Yeah, dang it.
Correct. So Matthew maintains his lead. It is a 2-point game, 6-4. Is that what you have, Nick?
That's what I have, Tim.
Let's get into round number two. How's it going to work?
Round number two is going to work like this. It is the wheel round. We have a wheel with 8 fandom categories on it, as well as spinners and opponent's choice. Each player will get a spin at the wheel. If they like what they spin the first time, they can keep it. If not, they can choose to spin again, but they will be forced to keep what they spin the second time. You'll get 5 questions in the chosen category, each worth 2 points apiece, unless you'd like to check down to multiple choice, at which point it'll only be worth 1. And be on the lookout as stealing is available in round number two. Tim, what's on the wheel today?
On your wheel today, we've got American Spies, Jimmy B, James Bond, YA, Marvel, Pixar, Law & Order, Disney Animation, and Worlds of DC. Matthew, would you like to spin first or defer?
Well, it's been a while since I've been able to do this, so I'll just defer.
All right. Nick, will be your spin, brought to you by Progressive.
Fair enough.
And it lands on YA.
Oh, that's tempting. Yeah, let's keep it.
All right. Nick, will you please read Nick's questions in YA?
I know.
Gladly, Nick, I'll be reading your questions in the category of YA. Are you prepared for them?
As ready as I'll ever be.
Your first question. In which YA film will you find an event called the St. Marco's Day Festival?
Oh, shit. Multiple choice.
All right, multiple choice options are, is it A, New Moon, B, Catching Fire, C, The Death Cure, or D, Divergent?
I'm gonna go with D, Divergent.
That is incorrect, Matthew. Chance for the 1 point steal. Your options again are A, New Moon, B, Catching Fire, C, The Death Cure, or D, Divergent.
I'll go C.
C is also incorrect. We're looking for A, Twilight, New Moon.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, I just watched that.
People in red.
Yeah.
All right, Nick, your second question. Who plays Jack, the leader of Kandor in Insurgent?
Jack. I hate to do it again, but multiple choice.
All right, multiple choice options are, is it A, Daniel Day Kim, B, Dominic Monaghan, C, Ken Leung, or D, Jorge Garcia?
A.
A is correct for 1 point. All right, Nick, your third question. In The Hunger Games: Catching Fire, how many living male victors from District 12 are there for Effie to pick from in the reaping?
I'm going to go for a 2.
2 is correct for 2 points. Okay. All right. Nick, your penultimate question. In The Scorch Trials, who gets infected by cranks when the group is attacked by them at the abandoned mall?
Newt?
That is incorrect. Matthew, chance for the 2 point steal.
Galley.
It is also incorrect. We're looking for Winston.
Winston, yes. Winston. Yeah. Okay, all right.
All right, Nick, your final question in YA. What does Aro have to do in order to read people's minds in the Twilight franchise?
Multiple choice.
All right, multiple choice options are, is it A, touch them, B, close his eyes, C, look into their eyes, or D, kiss them?
C?
C is incorrect, Matthew. Chance for the 1 point steal. Your options again are A, touch them, B, close his eyes, C, look into their eyes, or D, kiss them?
A?
A is correct for the 1 point steal.
Okay.
All right, Nick, if I'm not mistaken, I believe we are tied a 7-all after the steal there and the points that Nick got.
That is what I have, Tim.
All right, so we are going to bring back the wheel. This is going to be the spin for Matthew. Matthew, it lands on Worlds of DC.
Can you scroll down? I just wanted to take a look
at it. Yeah, of course.
I mean, I've seen all of these. I'll just take it.
You're going to take it?
Yeah.
Okay. Great, Matthew. I'll be giving you your questions in the category of Worlds of DC. Are you ready, kids?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Your first question. What is the only Worlds of DC film to feature Commissioner Gordon?
Justice League?
That is correct for 2 points. Your second question. Who directed Shazam, Fury of the Gods?
David F. Sandberg.
That is correct for 2 points. Your third question. The very beginning of Batman v Superman opens on a flashback to what type of event?
An alien invasion?
That is incorrect. Nick, chance for a 2 points here.
I'm gonna have to say, like, leveling of a city. I don't know. I'm not sure.
Both incorrect. Both had a scene in mind, but funeral is the answer.
We're okay.
Oh, okay.
Right. Okay.
Wayne's funeral.
So. Right. Yeah.
Okay. All right, Matthew, your next question. In Wonder Woman, which member of Diana's family dies on the beach when the Germans attack Themyscira?
Mother?
That is incorrect. Nick, chance for a 2 point steal.
I'm gonna go. Can I use a repeat here?
Yes, you can. Repeat.
Yeah.
In Wonder Woman, which member of Diana's family dies on the beach when the Germans attack Themyscira?
I think it's her aunt.
Aunt is correct for 2 points. That was a big 2 point steal for Nick. As we move back over to Matthew for your final question, Matthew. In Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom, Orm is being kept in a prison in which of the seven kingdoms?
I'll go multiple.
All right, your options are A, Brine, B, Zebel, C, the Trench, or D, Desert.
C?
C is incorrect. Nick, chance for a 1 point steal. Is it A, Brine, B, Zebel, C, the Trench, or D, Desert?
I'm going to go with Desert.
That is correct.
Oh, okay.
1 point steal. Terrible fucking movie. At the end of round number two, Matthew maintains his lead, but it's only a 1 point game. It is 11 to 10. Is that what you have, Nick?
That is what I have, Tim.
The tides are interesting on this one. Let's get into round number three. How's it going to work?
Mm-hmm. Round number three is going to work like this. It is the betting round. We have five more questions in the realm of Fandom Fights. Once the players hear the category, they can bet anywhere between 0 and 2 points on the question. If they get the question correct, they will gain those points. If they get the question incorrect, they will lose those points. We will play until someone is mathematically eliminated or we have reached the end of the match. Players, any questions? As we get into round number three.
Nope.
Go, Tim.
First category you can bet points on is Marvel. All right, Matthew, let's get bets starting with you.
Let's go two.
Okay, and Nick?
I went two safe, I guess. I went one.
All right, your question in the category of Marvel. What specific job does Eddie Brock get fired from in Spider-Man 3? You like Spider-Man 3, Nick?
No.
I remember seeing it opening night and not pleased. Granted, I was like
recently, since most comic book movies have been utterly disappointing, I've really been pushing for other like Spider-Man 3s to hit.
Hands down. Let's go to Matthew.
Is it photographer?
And Nick.
That's probably what I should have gone with. I went with pizza delivery guy.
Photographer is correct.
Oh, boy.
Nick will lose 1 point and go down to 9, but Matthew gains 2 and goes up to 13. Is that what you have, Nick?
That's what I have, Tim.
What's the next category?
Next category you can bet points on is YA.
Okay. Let's get bets, starting with Nick.
I went 2.
And Matthew?
I go 0.
Okay. What is the question, Nick?
Question is, which YA film sees both parents of the main character getting shot and killed?
Rough. Not a good day.
What? But that's what a dog says.
Hey, look, it's Eddie Brock. Well, actually, no, it's not. in that version of Venom is actually Harry Osborn. So that's fair.
You idiot.
Good game though. Good version of Venom. I enjoyed it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pens down. Let's go to Matthew, who bet 0.
Divergent.
And Nick.
I also went Divergent.
Divergent is correct. So big 2 points for Nick on that one. He gets up to 11. We're back to a 2-point game. The next category you can bet points on is DreamWorks Animation. Let's get bets, starting with Matthew.
2.
And Nick.
I got to stay in this game, so I'm going 2.
All right, big question here. Your guys' question in DreamWorks Animation is, who voices Mr. Wolf in The Bad Guys?
Do you know any bad guys?
Yeah.
Over, under, like, 8.5 bad guys.
Under, probably. Personally, no. No of? More. No, personally, I would say under.
Interesting.
5, 4.
I'd 3, say way over.
2, 1. Pens down. Let's go to Matthew.
Sam Rockwell.
And Nick.
Yeah, that's it. I couldn't pull it. I put Pedro Pascal.
And your winner, Matthew Chen. Sam Rockwell was the correct answer. Nick, a sad day here at Fandom Fight, but a hell of a match for these two guys. What'd you think?
No, what a way to go out. I think Nick left everything on the table. Reminds me of Michael when Michael went out. Like every game Michael played was very, very close. And I can't think far back enough to confidently say that every game Nick has ever played has been close. But at least this one and the last one, like this year, Nick has done very well. So it's sad to see him go. I'm glad to see the man because Matthew hasn't played since the beginning of this year. And he only played more recently in teams with Dylan. So the time off could have affected him very well. And I think it might have because we just regardless of it being retirement, we just saw a very, very good match today. Like. It was back and forth, like tied after Nick's spin, but then up by 1 after Matthew's spin. Like it was anyone's game, and I'm glad it was a good match. And I know, or I hope, we will be seeing both these players back in some form or another.
Absolutely. So let's go talk to the players in the post-match interviews.
Nick, Carley, sad day.
Yeah, I know.
As far as singles go,
and how appropriate it is that you are interviewing me for this.
Very true. But listen, I think this is good in a way because I think you've had a lot of success in a lot of other leagues, not just Fandom, but Melee. Like, I think you've done very, very well in Melee. Like, your rookie season, you were nominated for Rookie of the Year. You went on an undefeated streak there for a while. I think putting a lot of focus there could be very good. But also, you have a very successful history of Fandom teams, not just with you and I, but also with Albert. Fun fact. In fact, Big Guns is the highest ranked retired team that never won the belt. Like, Guns is a very highly ranked team. So if anything, I think this allows you to sort of focus on the leagues you've found more success in. But the matches you played in this year were very entertaining, very fun matches. So if anything, that's a consolation prize. But Nick, first, how are you feeling about the match today?
Well, I appreciate everything you said. I really do. It was one of those things. It was a lot of movies I hadn't gotten around to yet. Like you said, I think been concentrating more on just generic movies instead of all the fandom stuff, especially the new stuff that's been added. Especially with Nice. I've heard that movie's great. I haven't seen it. I need to see it. I've heard really good things.
DreamWorks about it. Been doing very well
recently. Yeah. Oh, I mean, it seems difficult for them to miss at this point, but anyways, it was a great match. Matthew's a great player. Like I said, I was shocked to see him in a retirement match just in general, because I know how good of a player he is. So, I'm happy I kept it close, and I got a couple steals, which were good. So that's, I kept it interesting until the very end. So that's about all I can ask for. And, I kind of got behind on fandom stuff. I love watching the matches, hopefully I will say I've had a couple people slide into my DMs for teams.
Sweet deal.
So hopefully that'll work out. So we'll,
awesome. Well, listen, I can promise you this right now. I will save you and your new team a debut spot at the beginning of next year.
Awesome.
Should you agree to any of those people that have slid?
It's unfortunate I lost, but I would like to give teams a shot too. So I feel like that I could get something going on that. So
awesome. Well, Nick, sounds like a plan. Again, sad to see you go, but we will be seeing you very soon.
Sounds good.
Matthew Chen, we may have been a little unfair to you. Not that you didn't deserve to be here. Like, you went on a long enough streak to where we were kind of like, okay, retirement match, but we didn't give you the most notice that people could. I think you probably found out this was a retirement match when we set the room up.
Yeah.
and I realized that, and I was like, oh shit, I feel like that's unfair. But I also thought to myself, like, if anyone's going to receive that news and roll with it and make sure that it goes his way, it's gonna be Matthew. And I think you did. It was a very close match. Like, Nick has clearly improved from when he first started, so I'm excited to see what team he gets on. He kept it close, but you definitely dialed in and focused in on this one to make sure that your fate didn't end today. But Matthew, there are three ways to go from winning a retirement match. You could be certain people that lose and then that win the retirement match and then lose three or four more in a row and wind up right back in the same spot. You could be no shot. You could be like Nazario and just win one and lose one and just perpetually float in the middle. Or you could be like Albert, who turned their full career around. On a scale of the first thing I said to Albert, with Nazario being the midpoint, where are you sort of leaning on going from here?
I mean, I'm hoping that it'll be more of the win one, lose one. I'm still having a lot of focus on Melee, and so it's really difficult to balance both. And I do have a ton of fun when I come and play in Fandom. It's a nice, relaxing, just no stress, except for a retirement match. But it is just still a lot of fun. So I'm hoping that it ends up being that. But maybe I can get him at a title shot. Who knows?
Cool. Well, listen, I would have said a similar thing to you if you had lost today, that You have great success over in Melee. You're doing very well with Dylan and teams. But now you get to see where your singles career sort of goes from here. And if the win for you is just never winding back up in this situation again, then I wish you the best of luck. But now that you've survived retirement, is there anyone out there you are looking to face off against next?
I'm honestly not sure. But anyone who's just maybe focus on Melee and just wants to do Fandom for fun, I'm like, let's do it. Let's have that.
Sounds like a plan. Matthew, congratulations on the win, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you.
All right, well, that's going to do it for us today at a very, very sad episode of Fandom Fights. We joke, we kid, but it is very sad every time we have to say goodbye. But, Can't schedule y'all. But it was a fun time. Thank you to Nick and Matthew. Nick, please get on a team. I hope people slid into his DMs and that he has a team coming. I'm super excited about that. Super excited to see what Matthew does next. So thank you, guys. Thank you to Nick for writing the match. I have been Tim.
Final act next week.
Whoa!
Yeah, check it out.
Merry Christmas, everybody. The final act is a coming. It's very exciting. So many things. Teams, singles, my hair stood up. Bye!